Hello viewers, welcome to my video series on biomolecules. So far in this series, I have described the general properties of carbohydrates, their classification, and the chemical reactions of monosaccharides. Besides, I have also explained the naming convention of carbohydrates and the convention of drawing their structures, Haworth structures and Fischer structures that we'll be using in this video extensively. With this, we are in a good position to move on with oligosaccharides. So, viewers, as I said earlier also, that oligo means few and saccharose means sugars. Oligosaccharides are carbohydrates made up of few sugar units. Means they are made up of monosaccharides and are formed by linking of monosaccharides through glycosidic linkages. That I have written here also. In this, monosaccharides are linked through glycosidic linkages, and these sugars are abundantly found in both plant and animal sources, and on hydrolysis they yield monosaccharides. First let us see the classification of oligosaccharides, and this classification is based on the number of monosaccharide units that are linked together to form a particular oligosaccharide. So as you see here, there are classes: disaccharides having two monosaccharide units, then trisaccharides having 3 sugar units, tetrasaccharides have 4 sugar units, pentasaccharides have 5, and so on up to 10 monosaccharide units. So of these disaccharides are most common, and they can be, see, all these classes except disaccharides are non-reducing, but disaccharides may be either reducing or non-reducing. So reducing type of disaccharides are those in which there is free carbonyl group, means carbonyl functional group is free on one of the sugars. So here they are also glycosyl aldoses or ketoses, and their examples are maltose, isomaltose, sulfuse, etc. Besides, there are non-reducing disaccharides which are glycosyl glycosides, means they have a glycosidic bond between the anomeric carbons of two sugars, so that there is no free functional group to give reducing reaction. So that's why they are non-reducing, and their examples are sucrose, means the common table sugar, and trihalose. Now before I describe oligosaccharides in detail, let me give a quick recap of the rules of drawing monosaccharide structures. This I explained in the previous video also, and here you see that here we have a D-glucose, for example, in open chain structure, and when we form closed structure, then it forms either alpha D-glucose or beta D-glucose, which folds into Haworth form like this, and this is how the numbering of the ring is done in case of alpha glucose and beta D glucose. Now you see that there is a very cool way of representing the same structures. See, instead of writing OH again and again, what we do is that the side on which OH is present, we just draw a line on that side, and the side of carbon atom towards which H is present, we don't draw a line. So for example, here on this side there is H group. So here we don't draw any line, and on this side there is OH group. So we draw a line towards the lower side. Again on this carbon, for example, you have H on top and OH on bottom. So what we do? We draw a line towards the bottom. In carbon third, we have OH on this side. So we draw a line this. So wherever there is an OH group, we draw a small line. So this is shorthand notation of drawing the same structures. And another thing that you should keep in mind while drawing oligosaccharide structures is how the structure will appear when you rotate the ring. So these are two methods in which you can rotate a pyranose ring of glucose. Just in this, O is on this side. This is the reflection of the same. As you see that when we make a reflection, then all the lines keep their original orientation. For example, the line that is pointing down here also. at the line that is pointing up is pointing up here also. But in another way, you can represent it by this structure, in which we invert the whole structure, and in that the orientation of all the lines becomes inverted. So these are two alternative representation of this alpha d glucose. Similarly, these two are alternative representation of beta d glucose. And if we apply the same to fructose structure that forms a furanose ring, so here you see fructose, d minus fructose in open chain structure, and this is the Fischer representation of the same that I described earlier also. The same is represented in Haworth structure here, and this is the shorthand notation of fructose structures on the same pattern that I just described. Means wherever there is an OH, we draw a line. On the side where there is OH, we draw a line, and on the side where there is H group, we don't draw any line. And the same thing on inverting this structure. So the fructose ring in inverted pattern will look like this. So students, keep this screenshot ready and refer to it whenever you are seeing any particular oligosaccharide structure or polysaccharide structure. Talking about disaccharides, let me first start with the example that is perhaps the simplest. I am talking about maltose, which is also called the malt sugar. This disaccharide is of relatively low occurrence in nature and is found in sprouts, etc. But it is also formed as a result of hydrolysis of starch. So as you see that its structure is formed by linking of two glucose molecules, one of which is necessarily alpha d glucose and another may be either alpha or beta. So these two glucose molecules are linked through 1,4 glycosidic linkage, in which position 1, you see that position 1 of one glucose molecule is linked with position number 4 of second glucose molecule. So the bond that is formed is formed here is, as you see, this is 1,4, this is 1,4 glycosidic bond. Now this glucose molecule is maybe either alpha or beta. So if it is alpha, as I have shown it here, so then it is alpha maltose. So for alpha maltose you will write alpha d glucose 1,4 alpha d gluco. So there is a 1,4 glycosidic bond between two alpha d glucose molecules, and when you have this bond between alpha d glucose and beta d glucose, then you get beta maltose. So these two forms, alpha maltose and beta maltose, can be interconverted because this group is free to rotate. So this alpha can change into beta. So alpha maltose can change into beta maltose. That means that maltose possesses mutual rotation, and it is also reducing in nature. Maltose can be hydrolyzed in the presence of enzymes diastase, which is found in malt, or in the presence of another enzyme called maltase, which is found in intestine. And one peculiar feature of maltase is that it hydrolyzes only alpha glycosidic bond. So whenever we have to determine in a polysaccharide whether there are alpha bonds or beta glycosidic bonds, we can use this particular enzyme. Now besides maltose, a related disaccharide is called isomaltose, which is also made up of two alpha glucose units, but is having different structure from maltose. Unlike maltose, which has 1,4 glycosidic linkage, isomaltose is having alpha 1,6 glycosidic linkage, in which one alpha d glucose is linked through another alpha d glucose through 1,6 bond, means carbon 1 of one ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल इज लिंक्ड टू कार्बन 6 ऑफ द अदर ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल. सो यू कैन नेम इट अल्फा डी ग्लूको पायरेनोसो 1,6 अल्फा डी ग्लूको पायरेनोस. अनदर डाइसेक्राइड इज सेलोब्यूज विच इज ऑफ वेरी लो अकरेंस एंड इज फॉर्म्ड एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ डाइजेशन ऑफ सेलुलोज बाई माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. सी दिस डाइसेक्राइड इज मेडअप ऑफ वन बीटा डी ग्लूकोज एंड अनदर अल्फा और बीटा ग्लूकोज एंड दीज टू मॉलिक्यूल्स आर लिंक थ्रू 1,4 ग्लाइकोसाइडिक लिंकेज. मीन्स कार्बन 1 ऑफ 1 बीटा डी ग्लूकोज इज लिंक टू कार्बन 4 ऑफ अनदर ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल विच मे बी आइदर अल्फा और बीटा. इफ द सेकेंड मॉलिक्यूल इज अल्फा हेयर इफ इट इज अल्फा देन इट इज कॉल्ड अल्फा सेलोब्यूज एंड इफ इट इज बीटा मीन्स बोथ द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर बीटा डी ग्लूकोज देन इट इज कॉल्ड बीटा सेलोब्यूज. सो ऑन डाइजेशन इट यील्ड्स बीटा ग्लूकोज आर अल्फा एंड बीटा ग्लूकोज एंड दिस डाइसेक्राइड इज रिड्यूसिंग इन नेचर. दिस बिकॉज ऑल्दो द कार्बन 1 ऑफ दिस ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल इज ट्रैप्ड इन दिस बॉन्ड बट दिस कार्बन 1 इज फ्री. दिस CHO ग्रुप इज फ्री है. सो इट कैन अज्यूम आइदर अल्फा और बीटा फॉर्म. सो इट कैन पजेस म्यूटा रोटेशन एंड इज रिड्यूसिंग इन नेचर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट डाइसेक्राइड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब इज वेरी अबंडेंट इन नेचर एंड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम फिजियोलॉजिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट लैक्टोज विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड मिल्क शुगर एंड इज ए कॉन्स्टिट्यूंट ऑफ ह्यूमन मिल्क एंड द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ लैक्टोज इन ह्यूमन मिल्क इज द हाइएस्ट अमंग एनिमल्स. इट इज हैविंग 6-8% एंड इन कंपेरिजन द काउज मिल्क इज हैविंग 4.8% ऑफ लैक्टोज एंड दैट इज द रीजन वाई ह्यूमन मिल्क इज स्वीटर कंपेयर टू काउज मिल्क. टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लैक्टोज लाइक सेलोवियस इट ऑल्सो एक्सिस्ट इन टू फॉर्म्स अल्फा लैक्टोज एंड बीटा लैक्टोज. एक्चुअली इट इज फॉर्म्ड ऑफ टू शुगर्स वन ऑफ विच इज बीटा गैलेक्टोज एंड यू सी दैट द फोर्थ पोजिशन इन गैलेक्टोज इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम फोर्थ पोजिशन ऑफ ग्लूकोज. इन ग्लूकोज ऑन फोर्थ पोजिशन इट वॉज OH ग्रुप वॉज ऑन डाउन पोजिशन डाउन साइड बट हेयर इट इज ऑन अपर साइड. सो इट डिफर दिस गैलेक्टोज डिफर्स फ्रॉम ग्लूकोज ओनली विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पोजिशन 4. Now, when a lactose molecule is formed, carbon 1 of galactose forms a 1,4 glycosidic linkage with carbon 4 of glucose molecule. And this glucose molecule may be either alpha or beta. If this glucose is alpha, then we have alpha lactose. And if it is beta, then beta lactose is formed. But this molecule is always beta galactose. So this is the structure of lactose and because it is having a free group here that makes this sugar reducing in nature and it also exhibits muta rotation. The specific rotation of alpha form is plus 90 and of beta form is plus 35 and both these forms form an equilibrium mixture with a specific rotation of 52.5 degree. Here it is quite interesting and useful for you to know one important aspect of lactose. See that every human baby is equipped with the ability to digest lactose because it possesses lactase in its intestine. But in case of several adults, it has been found that they are unable to digest lactose and it results in intestinal problems. And this deficiency of lactase enzyme, which results in the inability to digest lactose, is called lactose intolerance. So this is an important medical condition of concern in several ethnic groups found around the world. The next disaccharide that is very important is sucrose and this is also one of the most abundant disaccharides and it is the most common. We use it daily as table sugar. It is also called cane sugar and is present most abundantly in various plant sources. Students, as you see that sucrose is made up of one alpha D glucose molecule and one beta D fructose molecule in which alpha D glucose is linked to beta D fructose through 1,2 glycosidic linkage. As you see here, this 1,2 position 1 of glucose is bonded to position 2 of fructose. As you can see that whereas glucose is in pyranose conformation, the fructose is in furanose configuration. So you can name it like alpha D glucopyranose 1,2 beta D fructofuranose. So this is the structure of sucrose as I have explained earlier. Now here we are making the fructose molecule taking position 1 on this side. So as I explained to you that this is inverted orientation. So this will be the right position of groups attached to various carbon atoms. And now one interesting fact about sucrose is that it's a non-reducing sugar because both of its carbonyl carbons are bonded together. So that there is no free carbonyl group to give reducing reaction. And another important feature of sucrose is that the specific rotation of sucrose is positive. So this is a dextrorotating sugar. However, when we hydrolyze sucrose in the presence of an enzyme called invertase, it gives glucose molecule which has a specific rotation of 52.7 and beta D fructose which is having a rotation of minus 92. As you can see that the average specific rotation of these two products is minus 39.3 degree, and because it's minus, so the mixture becomes levorotatory, whereas sucrose was dextro. And since there is an inversion of specific rotation, that's why this reaction is called inversion and the enzyme is called invertase. The last disaccharide that I want to describe is trihalose. This is again a non-reducing sugar. This is non-reducing because in both the glucose molecules, carbon 1, which is the carbonyl carbon, is trapped in bond formation. So this is non-reducing in nature and it is found in hemolymph of insects where its role is to act as a source of stored energy. From trisaccharides, I have this example of raffinose, which is a 3-unit sugar having alpha D galactose bonded to alpha D glucose through 1,6 linkage, and that is bonded to beta D fructose through 1,2 glycosidic linkage. As you can see that this is simply sucrose. So if sucrose is added to galactose through 1,6 linkage, then we get raffinose. Next, from tetrasaccharides, I can furnish this specific example which is called stachyose. As you can see that in forming stachyose, I have added one more alpha D galactose molecule to the raffinose that I just described. So this was raffinose. See, this was sucrose, and when you added one more galactose, then it became raffinose, and by adding one more galactose to this, you get stachyose. And finally, the last example of oligosaccharide that I am going to describe is verbascose, which is a pentasaccharide. And as you can see that it is having 5 monosaccharide units. It is found by adding one galactose molecule to the previously described stachyose molecule. So if you up to this glucose and fructose, it was sucrose. If you added one more galactose, it became raffinose. By adding one more, you got stachyose, and by adding one more galactose molecule, you get this verbascose molecule. And lastly, I should mention that these three molecules, means raffinose, stachyose and verbascose, they are formed as a product of digestion of legumes. In the end, I would like to end my talk on oligosaccharides today with a summary of the important oligosaccharides that I have described in this lecture. So viewers, please do keep watching my videos and in the next lecture I will be discussing polysaccharides.